episode of Jacob's House of Rock. My name is Jacob, and today I've got a really, really, really exciting song reaction for you guys, and very exciting for me personally, because as many of you should know, I'm a huge Black Sabbath fan, and this, as far as I'm aware, is the first track that Tony Iommi, the guitarist of Black Sabbath, has recorded officially since Black Sabbath broke up. And that is so exciting to me because I was really worried that we wouldn't hear any more stuff from him. And especially this being on a track with Ozzy Osbourne, it's just, yeah, it's gonna be great. I am so excited for this one. So I previously recorded my reaction to Patient Number 9, the title track of Ozzy Osbourne's upcoming album, and I just recorded my first half of that video just now, and I'm just jumping right into recording this part of this video. So the way I do these song reactions these days is basically I listen to the track with you guys the first time, give my little commentary as I pause it and listen to it the first time. Then off screen, off camera, I listen to it in my own time a number of times, and then I do the conclusion to these videos. So I'm gonna do the conclusion to both this video and that video later on, but right now I'm filming the, you know, the first bit here. Yeah, let's see how this one will turn out. So I got the song ready and loaded here, and we can jump right in and see how it goes. I've been dying to listen to this one because I haven't had a good chance to actually do this video, record this video for the last few days. I would have actually done this on the same day it dropped, but unfortunately, yeah, I didn't have time for it. And so I've been like annoyed that I haven't been able to listen to this till now. But yeah, let's jump right in. Okay. That sounds like Iommi. Harmonica. Awesome. I wonder if that's Ozzy playing the harmonica, because back in the day he used to play the harmonica on all the tracks like The Wizard and stuff that had it in the you know, old days of Sabbath. So this could very well be Ozzy playing harmonica, which would be so cool. I have no idea who's on drums or bass on this track, but all I know is it's Ozzy Osbourne featuring Tony Iommi. So far, I'm digging the riff, I'm digging the guitar tone, because honestly, nobody has better guitar tone than Tony Iommi. There's some fantastic guitarists out there, probably definitely a bunch that are technically more skilled, some that are more famous, all that stuff, but for whatever reason, I just really bloody love that Black Sabbath sound. I'm gonna back that off a little bit. It's interesting because, like the previous song, this one, the beginning of it was quite heavy, but now it's gone into this chorus bit, which actually sounds quite light. And again, I wouldn't call this section metal. It's just gone into more of a rock section, or even slightly pop rock. We'll see. I gotta listen to more of it. It's just, I say pop rock, it's probably just more melodic. But I gotta listen to that change again, because I kind of missed it where I paused last time, how it sort of changes from the heavy to this lighter section. Yeah. Yeah, that was a good transition. You just start off with that heavy riff, and then you get the harmonica going in there, and it slowly kind of like mellows out into this section, and you got that really good melody. He's really good with those melodies there. I got the feeling this is going to be a very fun album. It's just got a colorful sound to it. It's a bit more upbeat in a lot of ways for a lot of his stuff. Yeah. I just want to go back a little bit. I just like that little guitar lick that just happened somewhere over here. There we go. The harmonica is a great touch. That guitar tone, it's just, yeah, so good, so good. Oh, look at that flanger effect. Some nice bass licks going on as well. I doubt it would be Geezer Butler on the bass here, because I figured if they'd have Geezer, they'd also mention it, but whoever's playing is just definitely trying to go for that sort of Geezer vibe, where he does do a lot of cool licks under a lot of those really heavy riffs that Tony's playing, and they kind of lock up and they play the riff back together, and that's like a really big part of that Sabbath sound as well. But yeah, I do like the way it kind of shifts in and out of like what's more of a typical Sabbath sound, and then more into this sort of like more melodic rock sound. Like this bit here, it's gonna go into a solo, which I just can't wait to listen to. But like this bit here, just that riff, that could have been taken straight off of 13 by Black Sabbath, that album. Really could have. While I'm a solo. Song's closing up here. Oh wait. Ah, the harmonica's a great touch. Yeah, okay. That was fun. I like that one. Really, I could listen to that heavy riff like on loop. I just love that sound. I really, dear God, I wish that Sabbath could put out another album. Like, I know they had 13, and then they had that like little the end EP and their final tour and all of that. But just it's just so much potential still there. So much more Sabbath that could be made. I don't know. I would make me so happy. But I'm really happy we finally get another track of Tony Iommi on guitar. I really just... If he puts out another solo album, that would make me so happy as well. Ozzy's great on this one. Really fun, like, melodies. For me, I think the chorus is a little repetitive. Like, I feel like they need, like, a little breakdown section where they change it up, and then they can come back at the end, which is something they do a lot in a lot of classic Sabbath that really makes it so engaging, and you can just listen to it forever. Just missing that bit here. Yeah, it does fit with that previous song on this album, so I'm getting like a much lighter feel on this album than some stuff, which is kind of, it's weird to say with a song with a riff that's as heavy and dark as this, and especially a lot of the themes that have kind of been on both of these tracks so far that I've listened to from this album, but it does have sort of a lighter, more rock, uplifting kind of a feel, very melodic in the way, especially in the choruses, very melodic and catchy in a lot of ways. Alright, let's talk about it. Degradation Rules. I've listened to it a number of times now. It's like a day or two after I've actually previously recorded the other segment. And it's such... It's Tony Iommi's sound. I'm just on listening to it back a few times. I had just like a really emotional moment at one point where I'm like, dear God, I really miss Black Sabbath. But in saying that, I will actually get to a bunch of nitpicks I do have about the song, because I didn't really talk about it too much on my initial listen, but the sound overall of the mix, I have a lot of problems with, and it's similar to what I talked about in my previous video about Patient Number 9. It's just they crushed the hell out of this thing in the mastering process, and there's something about the mix that feels really muffled. I don't know, like, what they did, but, like, it feels like there's a lack of space in this mix, and it just feels like you can really hear the instruments, like, struggling to get through, and it doesn't even feel like a loud mix, which is the weirdest thing. It's, like, the best way I can describe it is it feels like they crushed the mix, and then they turned the volume down a little bit and made it kind of muffled. It's bizarre to me. Which is a real shame, because the song itself, though I think it has elements of it that are a little bit too straightforward, a bit poppy, I don't know, I use the word poppy in a very different sense than I guess a lot of other people would, because it's still very, very, very far from what these days people consider pop, but I generally mean it to be a little bit more straightforward, a little bit simpler song structures, and more melodic kind of stuff, more upbeat. One part that I really still absolutely adore is, despite the atrocious mix, because the more I listen to it, it is really bad. The only thing that really sticks out in the mix is Ozzy's, I'm assuming it's Ozzy's, I really hope it is, the harmonica playing, which I really love. I really love that. But the only other thing that really sticks out and kind of saves it is that main riff. That, like, main riff that Tony plays, it sounds so good. I know that the production is terrible. It sounds like a really, really bad recording of a really good song at that moment. That's the best way I can explain it. But, you know, Tony's sound is just legendary, that even through the worst mix, it's still so good to listen to. So I really would want them to tweak that. Obviously, they're probably not going to at this point, but maybe one day we'll get a remaster, which to this day, oh my God, if I could get like any album remastered, I am just dying to hear a remaster of Black Sabbath 13, because that album has the same problem. It's just crushed to, it's not as bad as this recording, actually. This one sounds kind of weird and kind of lacking in presence and personality in some ways, which I feel like there was less of that on the Patient Number 9 song. There was a lot more clarity to that recording than this one. It's because Tony's guitar sound, I guess, is so kind of deep, it tends to lean towards that more bassy sort of muffled sound when it's not engineered properly. As for the song itself, I'm not going to comment too much on, say, the lyrics, although I did find the innuendo snick kind of entertaining. I like sort of that lighthearted play. And mentioning Red Tube at the end there was kind of on the nose, but you know what? Go for it. Why not? Although it does make me kind of really miss Geezer Butler actually being at the helm when it comes to the lyric side of like a Black Sabbath-y type song. He has a lot of sophistication to the way he writes things, and they're a little bit a little bit more going on there, a little bit deeper, which even on some of the more simple Sabbath songs lyrically were really interesting, like, you know, even on 13, like Pariah and stuff like that, kind of were on a similar level, but just had that extra edge to them, where this, I feel like this was, just like they put down whatever just to sound kind of cool and fun. I like it, I like it, and Ozzy does a great job on this track as well. So cool hearing some more Tony Iommi. It's just, dear God, please just get some better production. Just, you don't have to compress the hell out of everything. Like, listen to those 70s Sabbath albums. They sound amazing. Amazing. And they were so dynamic. They weren't compressed. And just those guitar tones and those are legendary for reasons, you know? Yeah, really great track. I don't really think it compares to most songs on, say, 13. But I do like that sort of more upbeat sound to it. And the contrast, especially with that heavy riff, it has that going on dynamically, where I think some of the stuff on 13 was sort of almost painfully doomy sounding, where I think Sabbath is a little bit stronger when they actually can kind of shift a little bit between playing around with some different kind of sounds and then offsetting those more heavy sounds. And that's kind of a fun thing that this song does. I had a blast of this one. I'm definitely going to have it as one of those songs that I come back to. Anyhow, thank you guys so much for checking out this video. I hope you enjoyed the song reaction, and hopefully I'll have more for you guys. So if there's anything you want me to react to, do let me know that in the comments below. And I'll see you in one of my future videos. But until then, keep on rocking, people. Peace out. Bye.